More importantly, what I would say is we need to stop this sort of myopic focus just on weight and fat. What we ought to be looking at is not just the change in what the person looks like, their body composition and their weight, but we ought to be looking at changes in function over time, because function is a tremendously useful predictor of the risk of death. There's multiple ways of looking at function. So you can look at cardiorespiratory fitness. And the reason why we care about cardiorespiratory fitness primarily is because it is far better, it is a far better predictor of the risk of all-cause death and death from cardiovascular causes than just knowing if someone's fat or not. So that's one way of looking at it. The other thing you can look at is muscular strength. Muscular strength also predicts the risk of death, survival, and so on. So that is what I mean by function. And some studies have looked at function in these patients that have been given these drugs. They typically have looked at change in something called 6-minute walk distance, which is the distance walked in about 6 minutes. But the change there has been minuscule. So we're looking at people that have lost maybe 10 to 25% body weight, but the improvement in their 6-minute walk distance was only about 10 meters, which is 33 feet. That's not a lot in 6 minutes, and that was about 5% in these studies. So it's quite small. So, you know, the presumption is, the cultural presumption often is that, you know, if you're no longer fat, you must be getting fitter. That's not true.